is this.
So you have an arm trap. From here you also have a neck trap. And then there's a shoulder trap and a body trap, okay? This is the arm trap. It's trapping the arm, okay? If I go this way here, okay, and he's dipping his head and his weight's way over on this side here, okay? And I know I'm not gonna be able to kind of sweep him out because he's, let's say even post up that foot, whatever it may be, okay? I'm gonna keep going this way here, because now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sit up and we get the neck trap, okay, from the arm trap. So this is the neck trap, okay? And with this neck trap, okay, depending on which way he's shifting his weight, if he pushes himself back on in here, I can get underneath here, take him up and over, and I have the neck trap right here. Okay. Now watch this. One. Here. And I set it here. Because from here, it's still somewhat undecided which way he's going to go. If I pull him down this way and he shifts his head to the right, you already have the arm lock right there. If he sees, I have to keep readjusting this right here. Okay, because sometimes it'll slip. I have to readjust. Okay. If I turn to this side here, okay, I have what I like to call neck traps, where you feed this lapel here. If he shifts his weight to the other side, come up here, and this is basically a neck trap. It goes under the neck, feed the far leg here, and here, take it this way, and get into the bow and arrow. You can lock it to the leg over the head, because it's twisting him up right here. It's very effective if you get it tightened. But now watch this. Here. We roll them to the left. So the one, two, three. Grab here. Okay. And now because I'm tight here, elbow tight. Okay. When my feet go down on the mat, my hips move that way. So I scoot underneath him. Okay. I'm not trying to roll him over me. I'm going to do this. Okay. Right here. Because now look. Need this right here, the neck trap, because you had that arm so far over. You don't even need to go to any S mounts or anything like that. Because look, because remember, I'm mounted here, right here. So you have this right here, several options. Okay, one nice option is an S mount, I can go here. Okay, I can just go here. Leg, I can pull them in for like a bow and arrow twister, or I can pull them down here so I can bring this leg over here, pull him, push his head, and I can also take his back here. Remember, if you have their back, okay, and you can feed this lapel here, okay, you have a lot of very effective neck traps from the back as well. Okay, so try this. Don't be too overzealous with this. Wait till they posture. And as he postures, I pull this right there. One, two, three. Here. Okay, I'm gonna pull him into my chest. As I'm trying to kind of move him this way, maybe move him this way, he pushes back into me. Here. Now. Remember, the lapel is in my right arm. My left hand's right here. All I gotta do is move it across here and just feed it. Hang on. And that's it. From here, you already have this caught. Because this is the same situation here. And then just go whichever way. Here. Here. However you want it. If this is too loose, sometimes I've ran into this, that I've had this too loose. him up.
I'm gonna go back to the back. Okay. For those of you who watched Gordon Ryan, okay, all he did was this. This and that. Right there.
This, basically. And just separated the arms from the back.
Alright, try it. 1, 2, 3. Tiger.